veggies grown in rock dust amended soil really taste better? I hope to answer this question by conducting blind taste tests. Back in June, I taste tested kale and collard greens. In that test, the greens grown in rock dust fared very well. I chose the rock dust greens as the best tasting 3 out of 4 times. For the blind tomato taste test, I wanted to get a few more people involved. In addition to my participation, my friends Brent and Amy also agreed to help out, as did my wife Karen. The tasters were asked to rank Sweet Million cherry tomatoes grown in 3 different field trial groups: the rock dust group, the biochar group, and the control group. All groups had the same base soil, but the rock dust group was amended with 1 pound of azomite per square foot, and the biochar group was amended with 0.5 pound of charged biochar per square foot. The control group had no additional amendments. The tasters were presented with 3 identical containers, each one containing tomatoes from a single group. The containers were labeled on the bottom to ensure the tasters were unaware of what tomatoes they were sampling. Brent was the first to go. He cut each tomato he sampled in half so he could go back and resample if needed before ranking the tomatoes. He also drank water after tasting each tomato in order to cleanse his palate. He enjoyed the flavor of all of the tomatoes and said they all tasted much better than the store-bought cherry tomatoes he had earlier in the day. Though he liked all of the tomatoes, Brent had a clear favorite and was able to rank the tomatoes from top to bottom. His favorite tomato was from the biochar group.
Brent picked biochar first.
His second favorite was from the control group.
Control group, second, and rock dust third.
And his least favorite was from the rock dust group. I then reshuffled the containers as Brent looked away. Following the same procedure, Brent repeated the process with 3 new tomatoes.
I'm sure. My wife might have a more discriminating palate than I do.
Once again, he chose the biochar tomato as his favorite. This time, however, he chose the rock dust tomato as his second favorite and the control tomato as his least favorite.
Okay. Number one, once again, biochar, same pick. This is rock dust, second. So you have a little different second pick. Mm-hmm. Of course, that leaves the control group.
All right.
That was it.
All right, great.
Thank you very much, Brent.
Thank you.
Brent's wife, Amy, was also kind enough to help out. Following the same procedures that Brent followed, Amy found that the tomatoes were very close in flavor, and it was difficult to rank them by taste. In the end, she went with her first instinct and ranked the control tomato first, the biochar tomato second, and the rock dust tomato last.
Bite, I thought I preferred this last bite.
All right, let's see what it is. This is number one. Control group.
Oh, shoot.
That's perfect.
I would probably go with my gut and not...
And I know what this is. Okay, biochar.
And this
rock
is...
Rock dust is last.
This is what? This is you last?
No, okay. Not at all. None of this reflects on me.
Okay.
For my taste test, I followed the same procedures described earlier. Karen prepared the tomatoes for me, and I had no idea which group was which. For my first round, I had a clear favorite. The other two tomatoes were more similar in taste, but I was able to rank them. I ranked the biochar tomato first, the control tomato second, and the rock dust tomato third.
Biochar. Control. Rock dust.
Before my second go-round, Karen shuffled the containers so I wouldn't know which container was which. Once again, the biochar tomato was my clear favorite. This time, however, the rock dust tomato was my second favorite, and the control tomato was my least favorite.
Biochar. Rock dust. Control.
Karen didn't want to appear on camera, but she helped out with the taste test anyway. On her first pass, she ranked the rock dust tomato first, the control tomato second, and the biochar tomato third. On her second pass, she ranked the biochar tomato first, the rock dust tomato second, and the control third. So now that all the testing is done, let's take a look at the numbers. We'll start with the average ranking. The biochar group is the clear winner with an average ranking of 1.43. The rock dust and control groups are tied with an average ranking of 2.29. Let's also take a look at how many times each group was ranked first. Once again, the biochar group is the clear favorite. ranking first 5 out of 7 times. Both the control and the Roctus groups were only ranked first once. And if we look at last place rankings, the control and Roctus groups both ranked last 3 out of 7 times. And the biochar group was ranked last only once. So with the Roctus results equal to the control and considerably worse than the biochar group, this year's tomato taste test results clearly do not support the claim that Roctus improves the flavor of vegetables. Of course, I won't leave it at that. I hope to do more blind taste tests this year and next year to be as fair and thorough as possible in assessing the claim that Roctus improves the flavor of vegetables. Before closing, I'd like to thank Brent, Amy, and Karen for their help. I really appreciate it. Well, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, remember, you can change the world 1 yard at a time.